Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, we're going to start a new chapter, Polygon Triangulations. The first part of this chapter is about an odd gallery problem. So what is an odd gallery problem? Consider an odd gallery like this, which has expensive paintings all over the wall. In daytime, guards can guard these paintings because they're quite expensive. We should guard them. But at nights, cameras should do this job. So we should place these cameras at strategic positions, such that each of them guards a large part of the gallery. So now, we have to find the answers for these two questions. How many cameras do we need? And where do we place these cameras? This is what we call it as an odd gallery problem. So gallery is in 3D world, but the mere floor plan can explain us the situation there, which is in 2D. Taking this advantage into consideration, the more precise problem statement of this odd gallery problem is, you will get an input of a simple polygon, which is the layout of this odd gallery, and should output the points in the polygon where we can place these cameras. So how many cameras do we need to guard a polygon? That depends upon the polygon. The more complex it is, the more cameras we need. For simple polygon like convex polygon, we just need one camera to do these things. But every polygon is not convex and everything is not that simple. So if we can triangulate the figure, triangulate the polygon like this, by placing one camera on each triangle, we can guard the entire polygon. But this seems like a good solution as of now. So how many triangles we can make out of this polygon? Well, there is a law for that. I'm not going to tell that and bore you. So the link of that will be given in the description. If you want to study about that law, well, go ahead. But the solution is, if I have a polygon of n vertices, after triangulating it, we get n minus 2 triangles of it. So now that we know n minus 2 triangles, and there will be n minus 2 triangles in a polygon. But placing one camera for each vertex is really an optimal solution. Placing one camera for each triangle may not be an optimal solution, because placing the camera at the diagonal, suppose consider this, can cover two triangles. Placing the camera at vertex like this can cover at least, these six triangles definitely will be under its surveillance. So placing the camera for each triangle in between anywhere is not an optimal solution. More optimum is placing camera at vertex. Is there a better one than this? Yes, there is a better one than this. We can do that by using a three coloring technique. So what is this three coloring technique? Well, in three coloring of a triangulated polygon, each and every triangle has a white, gray and black vertex like this shown here. So look at this picture. Each and every triangle has vertex with having three different colors: white, black, and gray. So how do we construct? How do we make this programmatically? Well, we do this by constructing a dual graph of triangles. In this graph, each and every triangle is a node, and there will be an edge connecting these two nodes if there is a common diagonal shared by those two triangles. So suppose consider this and this triangle, they share a common edge here. So these and these nodes are connected by a link. In that way, we'll construct a graph, a dual graph here. Now, what is the invariant is, all vertices of the already encountered triangle should be colored white, gray or black, and no two connected vertices will receive the same color. I think you got it. All the encountered, while we do a depth first traversal of this graph, while doing this depth first traversal, we maintain this invariant. What is that invariant is, all the vertices of the already encountered triangles have been colored white, gray or black, and no two connected vertices have received the same color. In that way, we will color each and every vertex, and we will form a three classes of vertices. Class 1 is of gray, 2 is of white, and 3 is of black. So placing, if suppose the number of gray vertices is less, So placing the camera only at the gray vertices will cover the entire polygon. So this is entirely an optimum solution for this odd gallery problem. So what is the proof of this three coloring technique? So consider this worst case where we have a polygon like this, and that is constructed such a way that there are n minus 3, this comb like structures, and these are prongs. So if the camera is placed somewhere in between, the camera cannot cover any other regions. So we need n minus 3 cameras to cover the entire ship. So placing that on top of the triangle can do this job. So we have proved that n minus 3 cameras are enough in the worst case. So it definitely will be impossible in any other cases too. I think you understood it very well, and thank you. If you like my content, please like and share and subscribe to my channel. For more technological videos, please continue watching mine. Thank you.